fuck you all to me means trust your own instincts. Don't listen to what everybody else has to say. Everybody else is gonna tell you, you're doing it wrong, do it this way, do it that way, don't do it at all.
That attracted me initially is that I was a participant or a fan of what was going on. You know, I was being inspired by the people around me, inspired by, you know, the things that I was hearing. You know, I mean, I was a skateboarder. That's why I started taking skateboard pictures. And these guys were so incredible. I just thought, you know, it needed to be portrayed in a way that I was seeing with my own two eyes that I wasn't seeing necessarily in the magazines. I was growing up at a good time and also kind of immersed myself into these things, you know, but it wasn't like anything unnatural. It was just like I was drawn to them, so I got into them. I mean, it's just my way. I don't fuck around. If I'm into it, I get into it. I know the people generally that I shoot, and that's why you could see their personalities and their character really come through, maybe in a way that you don't with other photographers all the time. And it's not about, you know, making them look good. It's, you know, making them look cool, really. You know, and also just telling the story of what's going on and capturing the intensity of the moment and of the day and of the culture. Whenever someone is doing something that is really, you know, out on the edge, that's really extreme, in a way that I know that they're doing it from their heart, it's because they have to do it, that inspires me. No one ever knew that it would last this long, any of these things. We thought we were just a part of these, you know, energetic movements of the moment, and that it would all soon fizzle away and we would all get real jobs. And, you know, I mean, even in the days of Tony Alva and Jay Adams, there were no pro skateboarders who were over 20 years old. With punk rock, it's like, you know, people just did it because they wanted to do it. When we were doing these things, the goal wasn't necessarily to keep it small. It was to inspire other people. I mean, that's what I do with all my photographs. That's what I'm always about, is just inspiring people. With hip hop, certainly in the beginning, you know, people were just trying to communicate, you know, certain ideas and ideals to other people and just having fun. You know, it was like Black Kid's version of punk rock.
So the fact that he found himself in the middle of that, at the very beginning of these three, you know, cultural revolutions, to me, that's like really inspiring, because he really did have a pulse on what was going on and what was important and what was real. He's the one that put those photographs in my bedroom or in my house or in everyone else's house.
We came up with the idea of, you know, maybe doing something with Shepard's collaboration. This space is probably the best suited, considering we've also had Shepard stuff in the show. I think it's one of the best presentations of the show that we've ever had.
The thing I first realized about Glen's work once I started to put together all the different subjects, photographs that he had done was, wow, this guy really had a knack for being in the thick of all the things that I care about. I really felt like Glen understood what was important in rebellious culture.
I mean, every time I have a show, I try to, you know, add a little something special to each particular venue if I can. Here in San Francisco, I added some pictures of Jello Biafra, you know, someone who was just like incredibly inspiring to me as a young, you know, as a teenager. There's also a Rick Blackheart photo in this show, Rick Blackheart being one of the original badasses in Northern California.
All these people in these photographs, when they started doing whatever they did, it wasn't welcomed by the mainstream. It didn't have commercial potential. You might be arrested for it. Not, you know, not gonna be running with a cool crowd for doing it. But in the end, skateboarding, punk rock, hip hop, all have changed the face of our culture in a really dramatic way. And Glen saw, you know, that the stuff wasn't being documented as well as it should be and presented it really powerfully. It's about harnessing that rebellion and that aggression that, you know, that music delivers firsthand, where you feel it, then you want to find out more about the lyrics of the songs or what the politics are of the people that are creating it, because it hits you in the gut. I try to make my art hit you in the gut. So I think that the spirit of Glen's work itself and his subjects is definitely thoroughly in the DNA of my work also.
I had no idea that it was going to have the impact that it did, you know. And, you know, these things didn't change the world, but they just changed a lot of things for youth and young people. And then when you grow up, you know, you take those attitudes with you into your workplace and into your families and stuff like that. And it's kind of exciting to see that, you know. I mean, Henry Rollins is going to be 50 years old, you know, in February. It's pretty thrilling, you know, to know that we've done all that and continue to do it. Haven't had to, you know, take any routes other than what we've kind of set out for ourselves. And hopefully that inspires people, you know, in itself.